set. I wanted to give a quick introduction just to those of us who are here. You know, some of us might not really have any idea what's about to happen, or we've never been to something like this before, so I thought an introduction might be helpful just so you can orient and set your heart towards the Lord in a proper manner for the evening. We're going to be doing 2 hours of prayer and worship. We're going to be worshiping with the Word, singing the Word of God back to Him, coming up with spontaneous choruses. If you would like to join in, all you have to do is listen and catch on to whatever the Spirit is breathing on. But I just wanted to just encourage you to relax, just to rest. When we worship like this, really every time we worship, we're just joining in with heaven. We're joining in with the four living creatures, all of the angels, all of the people, and giving God praise and giving Him glory. So just relax, just rest. You're not at work. You're just here. Take your guard down, all of your distractions, and just use this time to minister to the Lord. Allow Him to minister to you. But I just wanted to open us up in prayer, and please feel free to walk around, lay down, sit down. You don't have to do anything. There are no rules other than you worship Jesus and act like a human being. Father, I just thank You. Lord, I thank You for Your delight in us tonight. Lord, we just want to get into that river this evening. Lord, You have always loved us. You are love. You created us out of the overflow of Your own heart. God, I just pray that Your love would be tangible tonight. Father, that You would minister to us as we minister to You, as we lift Your name high in this house and give You the praise that You are so worthy of, Lord. God, I thank You that where two or more are gathered, that You're here with us. Jesus, I thank You for being here with us tonight. May we posture our hearts towards You in an attitude of worship and adoration and praise, because You and You alone are worthy. Thank You, Father, for Your unfailing, unquenchable, unending love for us. You loved us then, You love us now, and You will always love us. Thank You, Jesus.
Yeah.
Revelation 5, 8 through 14. When he had taken the scroll, four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each holding a harp and bowl full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, "Worthy are you to take the scroll and to break its seals, for you were slain and redeemed us to God with your blood, out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation. You have made us to be kings and priests to our God, and we will reign upon the earth." Then I looked and I heard the voice of many angels around the throne and the living creatures and elders, and the number of them were 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands and thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power, riches, and wisdom, and might, and honor, and glory, and blessing, and every created thing which is in heaven, and on the earth, and under the earth, and on the sea, and all the things in them." I heard saying, "To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing, and honor, and glory, and dominion forever and ever." Then the four living creatures can say, "Amen. Amen." And the elders fell down and worshiped him who lives forever and ever. Verse 8. When he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each holding a harp, golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. Father, we come to you tonight in the name of Jesus, and we lift our prayer and our praise and our worship, our intercession up before you, Lord. Let them ascend to you as incense in Jesus' name. Of our heart, that we would see the Lamb who was slain from the foundation of the world.
who has redeemed us by his blood and have made us kings and priests to our God. In Jesus' name.
Thank you. Confusion, no more bondage. Lord, we're asking that your blood would come in and break all of those things. 21. May he grant you out of the rich treasury of his glory to be strengthened with mighty power in the inner man by the Holy Spirit. May Christ, through your faith, dwell and make his permanent home in your hearts. May you be rooted deep in love and founded securely on love, that you may have the power to comprehend and grasp with all the saints how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. That you may come to know through experience for yourselves the love of Christ, which far surpasses knowledge. That you may be filled through all your being unto all the fullness of God. That you may have the richest measure of divine presence and become a body wholly filled and flooded with God himself. Now to him who, by the power that is at work within us, is able to carry out his purpose and do superabundantly far over and above all that we dare ask or think. To him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Verse 16. May God grant you out of the rich treasury of his glory to be strengthened with mighty power in the inner man by the Holy Spirit. Thank you, God, for strengthening us with the mighty power in our inner man by our precious Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name.
Oh, holy Spirit.
abundantly, far over and above all that we dare ask or think.
Thank you. Oh,
For always being here. Mm-hmm. For always being here. Anytime we come before you, Lord, you're waiting with your arms wide open. Mm-hmm. Lord, you are a good, good God. Mm-hmm. Lord, we thank you for pouring out your Spirit on us tonight, for being so faithful. If we come together twice a month, Lord, you're here. You're always here. You're always waiting. Lord, I pray that we will carry this out throughout our week, Lord, that we will live a life of prayer and worship and praise to you, that this won't be a twice a month thing, that we will pour out our adoration on you daily. Lord, fill us up with your love. Fill us up with your love. We love you, Jesus. Amen. We do this the first and third Monday of every month, 7 to 9. Feel free to come and worship with us anytime. We love having you here.